You can learn a lot about the physical properties of an element by reviewing the periodic table. Let's take a look at carbon as an example. The number that appears above the element symbol is called the atomic number. The atomic number tells you the number of protons that are in the nucleus of that atom. So in the case of carbon, you can see that it has 6 protons in its nucleus. In an atom of carbon that is neutral, there must also be 6 electrons. This is because the positive charge of carbon's protons must be balanced by the negative charge of carbon's electrons. Because electrons and protons have an equal and opposite charge, there must be an equal number of both protons and electrons in a neutral atom of an element. The number that appears below the element symbol is called the atomic mass. The mass of an atom depends on the number of protons, neutrons, and electrons it contains. However, since electrons are so small, their mass is assumed to be zero in most calculations. Therefore, the atomic mass of an atom is equal to the sum of its protons and neutrons. However, you'll notice that carbon has an atomic mass of 12.01. This is because the number associated with the atomic mass on a periodic table is equal to the average of its naturally occurring isotopes. All of the isotopes of carbon vary slightly in their atomic mass. When we average these together, we get 12.01. If you know the atomic number and atomic mass, you can determine the number of neutrons in an element. Simply subtract the atomic number, or the number of protons, from the atomic mass, the number of protons plus neutrons, and take the closest whole number. So 12.01 minus 6 equals 6.01, which rounds to 6. So the number of neutrons in a neutral atom of carbon is 6.